My name is Silalo Mujela.
My name is Mbuyisela Sokue.
We are qualified electronic technicians from Pretoria, South Africa. We have developed electronic systems to detect landmines. A landmine is actually a bomb that they plant on the ground. The purpose of planting landmines is to try to defeat enemies. When somebody steps on it, then they actually get killed by landmines. We've got two different types. Anti-personnel mine that explodes when somebody steps on it, and an anti-tank mine that explodes when somebody drives over it.
So we invented this robotic system to help detect explosives in dangerous areas.
The robot will be able to go and take air samples so that it can be known whether there are landmines within an area. We decided to go with an IP camera for our video feed and to be able to visualize the area that the robot is in. It will be transmitted through to a laptop.
This is actually the control to turn the robot. So you can turn it in any direction. The robot will drive to the designated area to take the air sample. And once it's in that area, the air pump will be switched on remotely, and with that sound indicates that the vacuum pump has been switched on and air sampling is taking place. The unit will suck in air through here, the air moves right through the filter, and then the air particles are trapped within the wire mesh. When the air sampling is finished, this filter is taken out and then it's taken to the dock unit so that they can do analysis and determine whether the area that is being sampled has explosives or not.
Dogs has the ability to smell between 10,000 and 100,000 times better than a human being. So that's why we use dogs for the explosives determination.
The robot air sampling doesn't really give you the exact position of the landmine that is being detected. After confirming that within an area there are landmines, a deminer will have to come manually and using a metal detector to identify where the specific place where the landmine is.
Suppose this is a landmine. Due to its sensitivity, it can't be moved. So the stand will be carefully put over it, and a pot with deflagration powder is put on top. All right, this is a deflagration powder. It consists of gunpowder and a bit of aluminium pieces. So this is what will burn when ignited by this igniter. So then these two wires need current through it, and when it starts burning, and it actually ignites that deflagration powder. This is called the igniter control box. This one is a fire button. So once you press here, then it gives a constant flow of current to the igniter. And it actually burns through that tin and burns the landmine. Suppose this is the landmine from there. It should be roughly, give or take, 500 meters away from the landmine. It has to be as safe as possible. This is the actual firing point. We are about to blow up a landmine. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, fire. It actually bends that landmine. That's how it destroys it. And you can see this is, it's like lava. You can see it's still hot, very, very hot. The mine will be just a piece of metal. The highest number of people who are hurt or killed are children, because they don't know what landmines are.
Kids are naturally curious, so they'll just go around and, you know, innocently play where they are not aware what's there.
By contributing to humanitarian demining, then we can save those people's lives. Saving somebody's lives makes us feel proud.